Toby Penty from England. There he is on screen right now, Toby in white, and that tough first round match against Kieran Merrilies, for whom and whom with he trains with Milton Keynes. Extending to the match extending to over an hour, eventually Toby Penty coming through in three, and then a very convincing win yesterday for the young Englishman against Raoul Musk. You can see on screen the schedule for today. Poor performance from the young Scots in the men's doubles. Constantine and Lo Ying Ping coming through, and then you got Bankier and Gilmour coming up later, and Blair and Hall to follow. With this men's singles third round match, as I said, is Toby Penty against Christian Lynn Thompson here live at the Emirates Arena in Glasgow. So after struggling in his opening match against Merrilies of Scotland, as I said, Toby Penty had a thoroughly convincing victory over Raoul Musk, the 15 seed. And Toby, of course, who has suffered from injury in the last year or so, is trying to put that behind him and get some momentum.
Please.
Christian Lynn Thompson, who seems to be around forever at this point. That's had two easy wins in a pretty decent draw for the Dane, beating James Farmer and Darren Adamson, both of England, in two games in his opening two rounds. So that's a bigger test, another Englishman to play against, but a bigger test for sure against Toby Penty. Head to head. These two players met 3 years ago with the Scottish International, and on that occasion, okay, it was Lind who was victorious in three.
Toby Penty, England. On my left, Christian Thomsen, Denmark.
So some local Scottish Thomsen, history Thomsen, between the pair.
Lafolle, play.
So the match gets underway. As always, Mark Phelan here with you, and delighted to have Ray Stevens behind me and beside me for this match. Ray, you're very welcome. Thanks for joining me. I've missed you for the last hour or so.
I was coaching a match on court.
Yeah, I saw you down there with Kukal, and a good win for Kukal in the men's singles.
Yes, it was a good win. It was a very interesting game, actually. And I think this one's going to be as well. It should be a good match, this.
Yeah, the well-travelled, as I said, Christian Lynn Thompson, been around a good few years now, the Dane. One thing you're always guaranteed with Lind is that his shirt will certainly come off. Always takes his shirt off, whether it's the interval or whether it's against Toby Penty, who struggled against Kieran Merrilies in the first round, but had a really good win yesterday. I think you were commentating on it, Ray, so you would know more about it than me, overall, must.
It was a very edgy match, actually, and two very different tactics being played. Raoul Musk looking for the rallying game, and Plenty being a little bit more attacking, which really paid dividends at the business end of the game. He's having a very good tournament, I think, really, beating Musk and Merrilies.
Yeah, I mentioned that just before you arrived, and it's been an easy draw so far for Lind. Two convincing wins over weaker English opposition. Again, another English opponent here, but certainly a stronger opponent for Lind in this third round. Of course, Toby really has been suffering with confidence in the last year or so. A little stumble for Lind on court, but it had hampered by injury over the last few months, year or so. And struggling just mentally, I think, to come back from it a little bit, Toby Penty.
2-3.
So many good men's singles players from Denmark. They're just producing one after another, and such a good club system out there that seems to produce the players.
Yeah, from a very young age, they're introduced to top-level competitive club badminton, of course. And with all the right coaching techniques and the full support behind their players from a very young age, it's no wonder they produce them almost on a conveyor belt year on year. Struggling a little bit at the moment with their women's singles, but a lot of young players coming behind the great Tina Bowen.
It's so hard to replace top class players when they do retire. Someone like Tina, who's played at the very highest level and won All England's, they leave a gap. It takes a long while to develop a player to maturity.
5-3.
So it's Christian Lynn Thompson with a 5-3 advantage early in this first game of this third round of the men's singles. Nice cross court. Oh, had the open court. Just failed to control the shuttle and keep it in.
6-3.
Interesting to see that Kenneth Jonasson is actually sitting in the court in the coach's chair for Christian Lind. Lind, who operates outside of the Danish national system, has done for many years now. And also Joachim Persson, who your man beat in that match in the coaching chair. Persson, who was world number 5 at one point in his career. Hampered not only by one dodgy knee, but a pair of knees that he's had multiple operations on over the years.
8-3.
The speed that he had when he was at world number 5 is clearly gone. Has to depend, you probably saw it a lot in his match against Kuka, to trust his backhand a lot. He doesn't have the speed to get around the shuttle, around the head as much as he used to.
That's absolutely right. And the longer the rallies went on, the more pain he was being got in. But such a skillful player, and got superb slices and uses the tactical ability so well.
So there's a commanding lead for Christian Lind in blue, furthest from the camera, nearest us in white for England, Toby Penty.
Having watched Toby Penty's previous two matches, he's actually being attacked a lot more in this game than he was in the previous matches, and it's showing a weaker side of his game, really. He's much happier when he's attacking players and being allowed to attack players.
Flick serve. Strange situation here for the last hour. It's calmed down a little bit now, Ray, but I'm sitting here and I had to put on my scarf and almost my coat because the breeze in the hall got up I think the TV crews are coming in for the weekend. There's major doors open. There's a lot of draft in the hall. And certainly down this left-hand side, I was seeing clears outside the line coming back in.
Right.
And I think it's just eased off a little bit now, but certainly for an hour there was the wind was strong. I'm just wondering, what was it felt down on court?
Well, when I was coaching earlier on, it wasn't too bad. It was about normal, but exactly as you're saying, in a big arena like this, all they've got to do is open a couple of doors or the air conditioning comes on and everything changes.
That's 3 points in a row for Toby Penty.
Nine.
Just narrowing the gap slightly. Christian Lind, forever the entertainer on court in his younger days for sure. You were always guaranteed sparks when Lind was on the court. Calmed down a little bit in his older years. Certainly an attacking player. The slice cross court, poor execution.
7-9.
Four in a row for Penty.
Yeah, I just get the feeling that Toby's feeling his way a bit more into this match and getting to Lind just that little bit more.
Yeah, good net from Lind. You saw the heavy spinning shuttle tumbling over the net, very difficult to control, and all Toby could really do was lift it. And the lift only half court. An easy winner for the day. That's a poor smash.
11-7.
Certainly a golden opportunity for Toby. The lift nowhere long enough. And in the end, it's the interval lead for the Dane, Christian Lind Thompson, 11-7. It was Penty who got off to the best start. Three quick points into a three love lead. But then nine in a row for the Dane. And he eased himself into a 9-3 lead. And then Penty coming back with four in a row. It's certainly been a seesaw match in terms of scoring. But the net result is the Dane with the interval lead, 11-7. And really, I think the match still struggling to find its rhythm and its direction, really.
Toby Penty is still within shouting distance, isn't he? He hasn't lost too many points at the moment not to come back strongly into this match. He's actually on the faster end at the moment, and I think he's going to be more comfortable when he gets up the other end, actually.
11-7, play.
Body smash, but well defended by Lind. Oh, and there's a bit of flair from the Dane. Super rally. And in the end, coming good. Best rally of the match so far. And the around the back defensive retrieval from Christian Lind, getting the shuttle back into the court. Certainly catching Toby Penty off guard. Yeah, and even if that was going to drop in, it was so high over the net, I think Lind would have been pouncing on it for a kill at the net.
Seems to be playing just a little bit more net. I wonder whether Kenneth Jonathan had said that to him in the interval.
14-7.
And rather than sort of smashing against Penty, he seems to be wanting to move him now. See, I think earlier in the match he was putting more power into those sort of shots, and now he's sort of moving Toby Penty more around the court, particularly with those drops.
Oh, oh yeah, just clipping the line. Toby Penty staring at the line judge, but no real argument from the Englishman. Chance to see it again here in replay. Yeah, good call. It's pretty much one-way traffic now, Ray. That's 8 points in a row for the Dane. I think Toby knows this one has gone beyond him.
Yep.
Sometimes you see this and you see players just backing off and saving some energy for the next game, but I wonder, is that the right tactic? Are you better to really trying to keep going? And you know, you might be able to change things around. You mightn't win the game, but you might get some feeling and get a run of points.
Yeah, you've got to try and tactically get into the match, haven't you? And at the moment, he's not really trying to find a way into that match. It's just retrieving at the moment.
Yeah.
Seems to have lost his focus a little bit in this game.
Poor backhand from Toby Penty.
But he's definitely moving Toby around the court. He's been told to move him, not to go all out attack on him. And I think Toby's got to find a way of putting a lot more pressure on Lynn than he is at the moment. And that's going to be taking the bird earlier and using his fine cuts. He's been so good in the tournament. This is a little bit unusual play.
And again, around the back, a little bit of showmanship from Lynn. You can afford to do that when you're 28 ahead. Tactical change, flick serve from Penty. A flying smash from the Dane, and that's the point he's been looking for, and a comfortable first game victory for Christian Lind Thompson. It was Penty who got off to the best start, you must remember, scoring 3 of his 8 points in the very first three rallies of the game, and a storming run of 9 in a row from Lind, and then another 4 in a row from Penty, before 11 in a row, I think it was, from Lind, before Penty stopped the rot. And then eventually Christian Lynn getting over the line. And you can see on screen. And here's the shirt change that I told you about. Always guaranteed with Christian Lynn. And Kenneth Jonasson. It's been a long time since I've seen Kenneth Jonasson working with Christian Lynn Thompson. Kenneth here with the Danish team this week. Hasn't travelled to Asia. Normally he'd be with their elite players in Hong Kong and China and Asia, or wherever they may be, in Scotland this week. And Toby Penty back out on court very quickly, ready to go.
But as you said, Denmark's got a few younger players over here, particularly the girls, and how lucky are they to have the advice from a past world-class player like Kenneth Jonasson, who's reached the very highest levels of men's singles.
Second game, the four, play.
It'd certainly be my choice of coach if you had a player out there.
Of course, still playing at quite a high level in the German league. And still winning matches, still terrorizing the league players of Europe. And kept himself so fit and healthy, and all the time, any time I'm around and I see Kenneth, and it's always Kenneth, he's running by me after like being out for 4.5 hours jogging or something, and he stops to have a chat, and puts me to shame, I think. And then he'll go out and train with the kids straight after or straight before, and beat most of them, to be honest.
I can imagine.
Yeah, and on top of it all, an absolute gentleman.
It's really important that Plenty makes a mark at the start of this match if he's going to get in it. He's looking just that little bit sharper, but he's just a bit defensive for me. In comparison to what we've seen in the previous rounds. And I don't quite... Perhaps he's a little bit tired from his previous matches, I'm not sure, but he's certainly just taking the shuttle a little bit later.
Speaking to Dan yesterday and earlier this morning, Dan's pet hate, Dan Travers that is all this tapping and touching each other in men's doubles, and he hates it, right? My pet hate, for anybody who wants to know, is when somebody changes their shirt and doesn't put back on the same colour.
Right.
I know it's pretty harmless, but you know, you get used to seeing the player in the same colour. And certainly, if for nothing else, the aesthetics of TV or whatever it may be, if the player wants to change his shirt, surely he should change it to the same one. So Christian Lind now in black. Late decision to take the shuttle from Lind.
And Toby Plenty in the middle of that rally, he just played a fantastic spinning net shot at the net that really got the opening. But Lind just lifted it to the back, and I think that's a sign of a really good player when they can take a spinning net shot like that and just lift it straight to the back.
Quite a flat game, though. There's not really much excitement in it, bar that one or two points in the first game where we saw a little bit of showmanship from Lind going around the back. But other than that, it's certainly not the highest quality. See Lind very much advanced right up in the net, anticipating the short return from Toby, and it racket nice and high to pull it across at the net.
That's exactly what I was just thinking, that he's taking the bird just that bit earlier than Toby Plenty is, and it's paying dividends in each rally.
Again, indecision from Lind in the rear court.
4-3.
And Plenty playing a rally much more like he's played in the last two rounds of the tournament. He's to me, he's been very defensive in this match, and it's not suited to his game.
Ah. Oh.
Service over.
Certainly taking his eye off the shuttle as he played that shot. Terrible drop. You could hear the shuttle pinging off the frame of the racket. Oh, that's a nice cross court, nice and steep from Penty. That looked to be going out. One of the longer rallies of the match. Beautiful net from Toby.
Toby Penty had Lind all around the court there, and he was just absorbing, and perhaps that's one of the things that has been different in this match, that Linda's just got that many more shuttles back. I mean, you saw him a couple of times, he's sort of been on the floor but still able to get a shuttle back. Have they played before, Mark, these two? Do you know?
Yeah, played once here at the Scottish in 2011. So that would have been probably in not here in the Emirates. Kelvin Hall, yeah, when it was a challenge event.
And was that Lynn's win there, do you know?
Yeah, Lynn won in three games.
Three games? Mm.
Too tight opening games, but easy in the third.
Service over 6-5.
That must be the first time that Toby's been ahead in this match.
Penty watching it. Eyeing the shuttle the whole way as it drifted out. Thought twice about it. Super net again from Lind, forcing the short lift, and in the end an easy smash winner.
Service over
6-8. Good anticipation, Lind anticipating that smash coming down the forehand side.
Service over 9-6.
Yep, certainly a different Toby Penty in this second game. Lind almost getting his racket around the shuttle.
Just a little bit sharper, isn't he? But if you looked at that rally there, both players playing the shuttle well into court. They're not looking for the extremities and the lines. They're just looking for the consistency.
Series of very poor points from Lind. some basic mistakes. You know, that was a very, very poor return of serve. Under no real pressure, putting it outside the doubles tram line, and decent start for Toby after a very, very disappointing opening game for the Englishman.
Looking sharper, he's taken the shuttle earlier, but I do think that Lind is quite good around the net. Takes a bird early. Got good spinning net shots. I'm sure Kenneth will be telling him now to apply a lot more pressure.
4-1, 20 seconds. 4-1, 20 seconds.
Both players back out on court. You can see the Emirates Arena in all its glory. Toby Penty serving to Christian Lind.
And that's a style that Toby's a lot more comfortable with, where he's clipping the shuttle down, looking for the net. This is his strong game.
Oh, that's a lovely smash. I was about to say just before that rally that Lind just started to look a little bit uninterested, but certainly refocused for that rally.
It can all change so quickly, can't it? A couple of points where it doesn't go for them and the head goes down, or a couple of points where it goes for them and they become very positive.
Oh, again, another basic error from Lind. A shot that he was so comfortable with in the opening game, that lovely cross net.
Service over.
A little bit of flamboyance. I think Christian, sensing that this game is drifting away from him, will just start to loosen up and start to play the flare shots. Again, it's not the first time we saw that cross-court lift drift out from the Dane. Struggling maybe with the wind in his back from this end, Lind.
That's definitely the way the drift is going, the way he's just hit the shuttle out, and towards the back line as well. But as you can see here, how far they're hitting the shuttle in, that they're certainly accommodating for the drift.
Service over, 9-14. Strong
defense, it must be said, from Toby Penty. It should have been a routine net kill for Lind. And all the things that went for him in the first game are suddenly going against him in this second. It's a commanding lead now for the Englishman. Nice stick smash cross court.
And that showed Plenty's strengths. He's put the slice in, then the stick smash, as you said, and then finished off at the net. And this is his real strength. This is what he should be looking to do.
A little break and play. Mopper required. Some perspiration on the court. At this point, we'll just remind you, send us your comments, questions, good or bad, using the Twitter hashtag SOGP. We'll do our best to answer or take any of your questions. Some tweets coming in congratulating Matthew Lo Ling Ping and Lauren Constantine on their victory in the men's doubles. A convincing win they had over the young Scottish duo.
Over 10, 16.
Josh Neal and Ben Torrance.
And Toby Plenty certainly applied the pressure in this second set by playing more attacking badminton, playing these sort of cuts and fine stick smashes that he's got.
Good rally.
And he didn't use one of those shots that I've talked about in that rally at all. And he doesn't look as comfortable when he's just rallying around like that. He produces a lot more pressure when he's playing these attacking clips that he's got.
Just pulling that one wide.
12,
just
16.
Beginning to sense a Lind comeback here, Ray.
Absolutely.
Starting to score 2 points for every one of Penty's.
Yes! Comes to her! 13, 16.
Lin's at his best when he's scrambling around the floor. And again, the scrambling defense from the Dane, keeping the shuttle in the court, managing the drift well, and that certainly landed out.
14,
he's getting a little
16.
Bit of sweat down.
Please.
He'll require a mopper. A lot of energy expelled in that rally by the Dane, but certainly there was two or three opportunities during that rally that Toby Penty should have put the shuttle away.
Totally agree. He'd hit on Lynn's body, got the weak net shot, and then kept it going, really, rather than really finishing it off and committing. But he was certainly trying for the point there, which he's got to do at 14-16. He cannot afford to just rally around with Lynn now.
Yeah, I think Christian just decided he doesn't want to go to three games. And 4 points in a row has taken him back to within two of Toby Penty. The Dane winning the first easy 21-8. The spirited fight back from the Englishman.
Yes!
Yeah, and all of a sudden the momentum switches back
15.
To the
16.
Danish side of the net. As you said, things can change so quickly in this game.
Toby Plenty's playing quite good shots, but it's just that Lind is really retrieving well. He's getting so much of it back that would put a lot of players under pressure.
Certainly after a mid-game low, the tempo has been lifted dramatically. And from nowhere, is back 16, level at 16 all. 7 points in a row for Christian Lind Thompson.
And he's got an enormous number of good shots back in that time. So all credit to Christian Lind Thompson there. It's really important that Toby keeps his head up now and believes that he can win this match.
The experience and the craft of Lind. After each of these long rallies, somehow he manages to get sweat on the floor, to get a mopper in, and then gets a towel down. And you can guarantee it, as it was there, another change of shuttle, so an extra 20 seconds to
takes
recover.
Takes a break.
Yeah.
And then re-energizes and back into the match.
Service over, 17-6.
Apologetic wave of the hand from Christian.
I think you're both going to see both these players going for it now. They're not going to just put the shuttle around it. They're both looking for the tighter situations and smashes and sort of where they're really trying to win the points, not just play the points.
Oh, that's beautiful play. Another little stick, a little bit of slice cross court. So steep, this one there, causing so much problems. And jumping across around the head with the cross court smash.
But nearly every shot in that rally, there was pressure on it. It was so they're both looking for the point now, which they've got to do at 17-all.
Toby getting a racket onto that smash. Oh, and a slip from Lind. Oh, and the mistake. And you can see Christian down 18, on the court, 17. Making sure he waggles and gets a little bit of sweat down there.
And it's going to be wiped again. Yep. Absolutely. You're right, Mark.
You can see it here. Down he goes. We didn't see it in the replay, but he'll stay there for long enough to get the perspiration on the floor. He's got the point, and now he's going to take the time to recover. Lind has won 10 of the last 11 points. Full stretch. The Dane staying down there as long as he can.
And all credit to him, because Toby certainly put the pressure on some of those points where Lind has got an enormous amount back.
So 40 minutes gone, 18-17. Toby Penty somehow managing to get his body out of the way.
And it's interesting in men's singles now, Mark, how much is hit at the body.
See it here. Oof, that was close.
Yeah.
Again, some more court maintenance required. And as the points get edgier and it gets closer, you'll see a lot more of this.
So all of those shots were aimed at his body, and you actually see this so much more in men's singles now, particularly at a high level, where they're pushing it at the player so that it can't get away from it. And often it'll be returned to the tee. And if you look at the play in that rally, it's nearly all played down the centre of the court.
19,
and this is because they want to be safer, that they get known replies from that. But it doesn't show confidence in the shot playing ability to move it really around the court.
Two flick serves in a row from Toby Penty. Yes. This time, the quick feet of Lynn getting behind the shuttle. And then getting the shuttle coming down. You see him coming back, body behind the shuttle. Good smash. Yeah, and that's the game Toby Penty likes to play.
Service over.
And it was a good switch of angles from Toby Penty there, and where he's hit straight and then moved it across court, which is really a good tactic. And if Lynn could have got to that, it would have only gone straight. So he knew where he was going in that game. He's playing a shot to look for a shot.
It's a game point for the Englishman. And it's been a long match. 3/4 of an hour for two sets of men's singles.
And the length must have been in this second set, really.
Yeah. Yeah, they can only come back straight, but somehow Lynn gets a racket on it. And again, diving cross court. A super rally to end the second game. And full credit to Toby Penty. Looked dead and buried in the first game. 19. Came out strong in the second, got into a good lead. You can see Christian Lynn diving across and up quickly and back again to try and get a racket on it. He'll go for everything, and against him you have to almost go for the lines, because, you know, he'll try and get a racket on absolutely every shuttle that comes over his side of the net. But towards the end then, Christian Lynn coming back and back and back at Toby Penty, and you have to tip your hat to the young Englishman. Stayed calm and stayed focused, and certainly in the last two rallies, played two rallies of badminton that he likes to play.
I think credit also to Christian Lynn Thompson. He has scraped so much back within those rallies where Plenty's been putting pressure on him, and I think that's been a feature of the matches, how much he's retrieved.
I think one thing that might be critical in this third game is it doesn't take a rocket scientist to work out that it's Christian Lynn Thompson who expelled most energy in that second game. So will he, and most likely, be the more fatigued of the two players going into a deciding set?
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
I think it's tough for both players, because I think you earlier mentioned that Christian's had a easier run into this stage of the tournament, whereas Plenty has really had tough matches to get to it, and it does take an effect as you go through.
Final game, love four, play.
Set underway, and it's the first blood and point to Christian Lynn Thompson. And with it comes the traditional and trademark fist pump from the Dane. Long match, 46 minutes, and just starting the third game. Two quick points for Lind.
So important to come out quick in a third set. There's a little bit of a lull at the start of a third set, and if you're not really up to it, the Danes particularly have a way of coming out where they take the pace up and take these early points. And a point at the start is exactly as a point at the end. So if you give cheap points away at the start, you pay for it.
I'm just looking off camera, Ray, and I can't help but my eyes being drawn down to the end court, and we've got the grizzly bear that is Ville Lang, and Ville has decided to don these long socks. And what a character. Might get to see him again soon on our TV court.
They're probably compression stockings, aren't they?
Yeah, that's what they are.
Yeah.
And they've stopped swelling.
And I have seen one or two players wearing that in the tournament. And even a real young player, the 16-year-old that you mentioned, was wearing compression stockings. So perhaps it's something we're going to start seeing a bit more in badminton.
It's normally the old grannies who wear them on flights.
Absolutely.
But Jano Jorgensen started wearing them, of course, in badminton. And
well, if he's wearing them, it's created a style already.
Yeah. So back to our live match. And it's a good start to this deciding set by Christian Lynn Thompson. Quickly into a 4-1 lead.
Who's been on the attack, hasn't he? And if you looked at how hard Toby Plenty had to work for that second set, it's his strength was in his attack. He can't allow Christian Lynn Thompson to take the attack.
That's a nice control. Three-quarter stick smash down the line. And Penty, accuracy rather than power. Again, Lind diving to retrieve the shuttle.
3-5.
Getting some sweat down again, getting a time, getting a breather. And you can see by the time Toby Penty gets to his box, Christian Lind has already had 10 seconds ahead of him to recover.
And it's enormous, these rest breaks, because the players would actually be training this energy system so that they, if they get, can extend a rest break from 10 seconds to 40 seconds by doing up their shoes or getting the court wiped or toweling down, they've already recovered for the next rally by then.
Sometimes you see that with Toby. When he goes for the real full power smash, mistimes it, gets up in the air. Let's see, does he take his eye off it? Oh, I don't know, just doesn't seem to extend the arm. The elbow seems to be stuck a little bit into his side.
Yeah, and I'm going to blame his balancing arm there because it was down by his side.
Yeah, true.
Amazing get backs, yeah. Amazing.
On equally good from Penty, and a good rally from both men.
7-4.
And I think Toby will be a little bit frustrated that he didn't close out that rally earlier. Once again, we have this break in play. And certainly, the further we go into this match, the more times we're going to see Christian Lynn Thompson on the floor. And as a result, the more breaks we're going to see. Moppers needed.
which is something really the umpire has to take control of. Play should be continuous, and I've seen it a few times in this tournament where people are really taking their breaks and being able to take advantage of it. Okay, that's part of the game as well, that they do that, but it's the umpire that has to control it and bring the players to rule. Superb net kill by Plenty there, and reading that it was going to be a net shot. And that was a very fine kill.
Yeah, right on the line.
7-all.
And after 53 minutes, 54 minutes, nothing to separate these men. One set all, 7-all in the deciding game.
That was tight, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Just get the impression now that Lind is trying to apply the pressure on Toby, and it's whether it, and that always expends more energy.
Clearly both men really trying to extend the time between the rallies, using up as much time, getting as much time as possible to recover. We're nearly an hour into this match and there's still at least 15, 20 odd minutes to go, and physically demanding.
Oh,
a little bit of showmanship from Lind. I've seen it so many times in the past, so I'll see it here again.
Looks like he's going to hit it, and believe me, that's so frustrating for his opponent, because he's getting ready for the next shot, and really, it's like playing a joke on your opponent.
Slightly cheeky.
It is. And also perhaps his way of relieving the pressure a little bit.
Mistake from Toby, but what's more important is there's going to be another break in play. Lind on the ground once again.
And Lind really got away with that rally, didn't he? Should have, Toby should have nailed it.
Yeah, nailed it much earlier.
Amazing the get backs that he's got.
Oh, how close was that to going over?
Mm.
Slid along the net court.
And you get the impression that if it had, Lind would have dived for that one as well. He's shown amazing retrieving ability. Yeah.
Lind, who goes to the interval break on these toes. Toby just a little bit flat-footed and a little bit almost frustrated, you can say, of the Englishman. But certainly at 11-8 ahead, it's Lind who has the advantage. I think it was 4 points in a row, taking him into that lead. But it's been such an up-and-down seesaw battle. We saw it in the first game where Lind won 5 or 6 and Penty came back and won 4. And it hasn't been a match where they've been neck and neck, point for point. It's been waves of attack from either side of the net. And once again in this game, Lind getting a lead, Penty coming back, and then Lind taking 4 points in a row to get into the interval in the lead. Seesawing back and forth.
And third shirt you're on now.
Third shirt, yeah.
11-8.
Lisa's black, play. Same colour as the previous one.
Something we're seeing though is that Lind is using the attack to Toby's body a lot more now than he has previously in the match. Tough rally this.
It's this time Toby Penty is getting the look. Because Christian Lind really had an opportunity to put that away.
Yeah, Toby was on the wrong end of that rally, wasn't he? And yep, then he got away with it.
All he had to do was pull that cross court at the net. Nice and easy shot. He was up nice and early to it.
Yeah. And that will encourage Toby.
Always guaranteed a long match with Christian Lind. Likes to get into some rallies. One of the longest matches I've ever had to sit through and commentate on was, of course, Lind against Villelang. Two guys who will just hit it back and forth all day long. I think it was an hour and a half.
Good point for Toby there, though. Just playing it simply across court. And I think that's what you've got to do. When he's under extreme pressure and he's doing these dives and everything like that, just play it simply into the court. Don't try and get too much out of it.
Another one of these exhausting rallies. That's a Dane who comes out on top. The only positive thing is he didn't have to go on the floor, so we'll get the next rally pretty quick. Oh, now he wants to tie his lace.
And that'd be a good 20 seconds. But fine shot, Christian just played to win the point, slice across court. So they're all pressure shots that they're looking for.
Lind getting the look off the net.
Service over, 11.
Working hard again. Toby Penty coming forward. Somehow, let's see it here. The smash coming in. Lind getting the shuttle back. Just clipping the net. Toby getting a racket on it.
Pushes it long, doesn't he?
Pushes it long, yeah.
And that end, that's the drift is going towards that back line.
I think it was more to do with, I don't think Christian really expected Toby to get anything on it. And we're on the ground again, so we can guarantee another mopping session. Lynn just taking his time.
Do you think he's stretching it a bit, Mark? Do you think he's?
Absolutely.
I think he is. I know. I think if I was on the other side and I was Toby, I'd be absolutely raging.
Discussion going on now between Christian Lynn and the umpire. I'm not quite sure what it's about.
Try and use your feet.
Yeah.
Make a great goalkeeper. But as you well know, Mark, he's one of the characters on the circuit, isn't he, Christian? He's
you know, the fact of the matter is this match, of all the five that are on court right now, is the centre of attention. It's gone to three games. It's close. The eyes of the arena are on it, and he loves that attention. And that's when you get the best from him also, because he plays to the crowd and... this match ain't finished yet, and we're sure to see some plenty of diving and crazy defensive retrievals from Lind.
Yes.
Oh, Toby, poor mistake.
14-12.
But a two-point buffer like this at 14-12, you and I both know it's so important to try and just make that buffer. It enables you to play a little bit, with a little bit more freedom on your shots. You'll try a little bit more, and that's quite important to play well. Whereas what will be happening with Toby now, he'll be having to take less risks because... Christian Lynn Thompson has just made that break away from, even if it's just one or two points. I think if Toby's going to win this match, he's got to get back to his attacking play. And it's not easy.
A good view. We've seen drift over this baseline from Penty, and we certainly shouldn't. We don't expect that, given that Toby's playing into the wind. Of course, it comes. You know, we're in the third game of 65 minutes in this match so far. Both players are getting tired. Mentally, it's just starting to get drained.
And they're probably both going to have to go on the attack in the last sort of 5 points of this match, and that's not easy.
Nice block defense from Penty.
Yes!
Yeah. And Lind putting the smash right back into the body
16,
of Penty.
13.
Toby hadn't recovered.
And both smashes that he played in that rally were both at the body. So that's when they take in less risks.
I think this is a huge point for Toby Penty. Cannot afford to go four behind, I think.
Good
smash.
Shot from.
Yeah, beautiful. Cross the body
cross
of his
smash.
Opponent.
70.
And that mark, that's exactly the shot he shouldn't play, because he was basically playing it back into Toby's area. But that's why it was such a great shot.
You can see after, you're just missing it, but Christian Lind telling the umpire that he wanted a towel down, not asking. And Toby Penty standing there with his hands in the air at the umpire. What's going on? You know,
yeah.
Let's keep playing. Drifting away now from the Englishman.
It was weak play, that.
18, 13.
4 points on the bounce for Christian Lynn Thompson.
So you're seeing that Toby's taking up the pace here. He's either going to stay in the tournament or go out, and it's he's going to take this pace up the last bit.
And again, the showboating from Lind at the end of the rally. Coming in quick. Finishing it off. Again, that rally going longer than it should have. Toby Penty,
14,
four shots in the end of that rally. Should have killed it off with a net kill. But in the
good
end,
shot, though.
Yeah, it's good cross net, sticking at it. Still trailing by five, the Englishman. Another break in play.
Which is probably just a bit too much, isn't it, Mark, to pull this match off, I think. I think the break has been made.
Play.
Yeah, I think it's a decisive break, that 5 points in a row from Christian Lind.
Yes!
Good acceleration. And the power that takes the Dane to match point.
And again, attacking the body. You see that so much more now in top class singles.
Okay. There it is in the end, and Lynn turns and showboats the crowd. It's the Danish strut of Christian Lynn Thompson. Convincing in the end. Good first game from the Dane. Good spirited fight back in the end. And the second from Toby Penty. And we thought Toby was going to come true and win in the third.
Match won by Christian Thompson.
But in the end, the experience, I think, and the court management, let's call it, of Christian Lynn Thompson. Not just outplaying Toby Penty, but mentally breaking him down with all the breaks in play, as Christian Lind is so good at. And the first real test for Lind, and he's come through in flying colours. And as you can see in the replay, turns and faces the crowd.
There you go.
Fist to the camera, he's happy. And they leave the court, 3-game victory to Christian Lind Thompson. He advances to the next round. Applause from the crowd. We're going to take a short break, and then we'll be back with the next match, and it'll be the women's doubles, and for Scotland, third seeds Bankier and Gilmour against Emily Fabeke of Sweden and her Danish partner, Lena Graybeck.